Hi, I'm Gary Edwards. This is another in our series of lighting tutorials where we show you how simple it is to light things that a lot of people think are complicated. And one of the subjects that people really struggle with is glass. Today we're going to photograph a very simple wine bottle. I'm going to show you how it's done. And once I've shown you the principles, you'll turn out excellent results. And after that, we'll move on to something more complicated. One of the things that people struggle with is lighting glass. Now, glass is a bit special because you can't light glass because, of course, it's invisible. So all that we light in photographic terms is the effect that the glass has on the light that passes through it and on the light that is reflected from it. Now, I've started off with a very, very simple shape here. It's an ordinary wine bottle. It has the usual little indentation at the bottom, which makes it look as if there's more wine in there than there is. It has no markings on it, no engravings on it of any kind. The only thing that we've done to this, which you must always do with a wine bottle, is take off all the labels that are stuck on the back and the side that give you essential information that nobody ever reads. So we're just photographing the front of it and the label, because let's assume that we're actually producing an advertising shot for this wonderful bottle of Chardonnay. Okay, there's various ways of doing it. Today I'm going to show you how to do simple white field lighting and then add a little bit of extras. White field lighting is where we don't light the subject itself, we simply pass light through it. I'm going to keep it very simple. I'm going to stick it on this little piece of shiny acrylic. I'll stick it on the back, and before I actually take the shot, so I'll go back to camera position and I'll make absolutely sure that it's dead square so the label is filling the frame, because if it's a millimeter out it will look awful. But we'll do that bit in a minute. Now this is going to give us a semi-reflection. If you don't want a semi-reflection, no problem, just use a different background. Okay, now the light itself that's going to pass through it, I've already set up a softbox. I'm using the softbox to provide a white background and to shine light through the actual glass. Now, I don't know how much you're going to be able to see with video lighting getting in the way, but you may see that this lights up when I turn it on. Obviously, studio lights are adjustable for power. It's a bit more difficult sometimes if you're not using studio lights to get the right effect, because what this does, because it's a studio light, it fills the softbox properly and gives nice even lighting. And we then just mess around with the power adjustment until it's the right amount of light passing through the bottle. And you can see in the shot that's on the screen now, we've got a semi-reflection here, and it's the work of a moment in Photoshop just to make the back of this blend nicely with the white background. So no problem at all there. And on the screen now you can see the finished shot as we have it at the moment. So now we have a shot. As you can see, it is just the light that's passing through the bottle, and it's sort of working. And it would work even better if we put glasses with it, because it would have the same effect of outlining the edges of the glasses, but it does give a rather strange effect on the glasswork itself, doesn't it? So there's another way around that, and what we do is we introduce strip softboxes. And strip softboxes, in fact, though they're now used for all sorts of things, because as photographers we're quite inventive people, they were actually designed specifically for lighting wine bottles. So I put those in. We've got the first one in position, and now you can see on the screen the effect that this is having with just one in place. And we now add another one. So here we are with two strip softboxes, one each side, both behind the subject, And as you can see in the finished result, it's lighting the edge and it's doing a much better job than we had before. Now, for the sake of a video, I'm just showing you how it's done. You will have to fiddle a bit and make fine adjustments, because moving a softbox 5 centimetres would make a massive change to the finished result, and we're normally moving them a couple of millimetres at a time to get the strips that you're seeing down here, which are called diffused specular highlights, exactly in the right place and even. But here we are, this is the finished result. Now, you can also, of course, you wouldn't use a white base for this, but you might want it against a black background and use just these. Now, if I turn off that light at the back, now with the light turned off at the back, we've got a totally different result. Now you might think, well, hang on a moment, even with the light turned off, it's still white. Why is it showing as black? Well, it's showing as black because these two lights here are only illuminating the bottle and they are not reaching the background at all. And of course, a white background that doesn't get light on it is black. So if you do want to do this against a black background, don't worry about the background because it won't make a scrap of difference. You can use anything you like. And basically, that's it. All that remains now is to try out the wine and see what it tastes like. Got this metal, or metallic, I suppose, plaque, Gentleman Jack.